like show business if you tell me it's so.
Traveling through the country is so thrilling.
Standing out in front on opening nights.
Smiling as you watch the benches filling and see your billing out there in lights.
There's no people like show people. They smile when they are low.
Even with a turkey that you know will fold,
you may be stranded out in the cold.
Still you wouldn't change it for a sack of gold.
Let's go on with the show.
Centennial Variety Show. You're going to have so much fun tonight. You're going to see a lot of friends and neighbors, colleagues, and even some community officials reenacting the way Briarcliff was in the early 1900s and taking us right through to contemporary life in the village as we know it today. The program that you have is really going to help you get through Act 1 because we're not going to introduce each scene. But when you see the people up here, I'm sure you'll know who they are. Act 2 is all historical, and there is so much history in this village, so much to learn from, and you will learn a lot tonight. Walter Law will be narrating much of it, so you'll be able to follow exactly what's happening in Act 2. So at this point, I just want everybody to sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Thank you.
Dozed off there for a minute, but I seem to have slept a lot longer than that. Rip Van Winkle, move over. My name is Walter William Law, and I had an instrumental role in the founding of your village in the early part of the last century. But this evening is not about me, it's about you and this special corner of America. I'm happy to be here tonight. Actually, I'm happy to be anywhere tonight since I passed on in 1924. And now that I am awake, I remember why I am here. The folks upstairs thought it was very, very important for me to come back and make sure everything is in order, some 112 years after I started it all. That's right. Made my first land purchase here in 1890, when the area was still called Whitson's Corners, 232 acres. And 12 years later, when we incorporated, on November 21st, 1902, we had all of 331 citizens. Times have certainly changed. Your lives put our us dairy farmers to shame. So sophisticated. The machines, the language, the music. Virtual link point? What's up? Goo Goo Dolls? It boggles me. And purely local things are all Greek to me, too. Like the mounds of dirt that congregate around the schools in this village. Do they have some deep-seated significance like the markings at Nazca in South America? And all the anxious conversations about card playing. I played a little bridge when I was younger, but these heated discussions around town about Trump and no Trump, I just don't understand it. And what on earth is a millennium pipeline? Does it move millennia from one area to another? Well, I'm sure you'll have questions for me too. But as noble citizens and friends of this inspiring, small, independent New York town, I have some questions for you as well. Where are you going in this blessed village? What do you hope to achieve? Are you just players alone on the stage here? Or do you really believe? Now when it all started, a long 100 years past, our mission was clear and alive. To live as good neighbors, to help one another, to make sure the young ones would thrive. But now it's all changed so, the pace is so frazzling, with gridlock and padlocks and such. We've gotten away from the things that uplift us, like talking and feeling and touch. Well, maybe this evening we'll catch just a glimpse of past glories and those still to come. Now, if that can happen, I'll go upstairs gladly, knowing my work here is done. And so, my friends, let's take a look at Briarcliff Manor, past and present. What makes it tick? What makes it different? What makes it special for you and me? And what cosmic forces, strange cosmic forces, have placed us together here in this auditorium and place 100 years after this town was cobbled together, just 28 miles north of Times Square and beautifully situated halfway between Reader's Digest and Sing Sing Prison? Are you ready? Enjoy yourselves. I won't be far away. And now, to get us started, here's a very important organization in town known as the PT&A.
Pasta and glimpses made some kids unwell. When the phone rings, there's that class trip and the school ladies and gentlemen, you better believe our mayor, Keith Austin, cannot be with us tonight. Keith is vacationing with his wife in China, but he has sent a message to all the good people of Briarcliff and has asked me to deliver it, which I'll be very happy to do. So here is the mayor's message all the way from China. Ni hao, wo shao qian hui hong ni ho. Pen hao qian jin wan wu fa. Bing dong yui tang ho, Briarcliff Manor. At this point, the message abruptly ended. What he really wanted to do with the message was to say that he wanted to invite all of you here tonight to witness a typical Briarcliff Manor Board of Trustees meeting. I must tell you that these are usually so dull that they would bore the enamel off your teeth. This one tonight is just a little bit different, so watch up and follow me. Now, as acting mayor, I am calling for a vote on this measure. All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Nay. The ayes have. Now, before we adjourn, I suggest we do what we always do with this joke when the mayor is here. Why don't we all sing the Board of Trustees fight song? What do you think? Let's do it. So let's go to the women aid, please.
Oh.
Visited Briarcliff Manor and fell in love with it. So he purchased these 700 acres and built a Girl Scout leading training center in honor of his wife, Edith. In fact, the old stone house still stands over there, right back on Old Chappaqua Road. Oh, back then, they used to call it the University in the Woods. And today, we call it the Edith Macy Conference Center. Did you know that we officially started selling cookies way back in 1936? That's when the Thin Mints hit the scene, and they're still selling today.
That's because they're so good.
And you are so right. And speaking of cookies, come and try our tasty treats. If you're feeling low and you need a lift, cookies can be beat. When your cares seem so extreme, just forget your woes and reach for that box of those cookies filled with cream. Half a Samoa and before you know it, your blues will melt away. We don't want to tease ya, the thing that's in the freezer will surely make your day. So when that doorbell rings, don't refuse, 'cause if you do, I'm telling you, you'll get the Girl Scout cookie. Talk about the cookie, Girl Scout cookie blues.
Thank you. Good afternoon, sir. Can you tell me where I can purchase a round-trip ticket to Highbridge? And where are they hiding the railroad tracks?
Why, aren't you Andrew Carnegie?
I am indeed, Andrew Carnegie, man of steel. What makes you think Walker Law is the first, sir, only one that can return here? He's checking out the entire village, but I wanted to check on my personal passion, libraries. But first, I wanted one more try to the choo-choo train.
I'm sorry, Mr. Carnegie, but the train stopped running here in 1962, and this has been the public library since 1959. In fact, this is the fifth public library since 1914. You'd think by now we'd have an adequate facility. Come on, I'll show you how small it is.
Take long! 612 Briarcliff. All fire department members, emergency at Briarcliff High School auditorium.
Car 2051 responding, Briarcliff High School.
Car 2053 responding, Briarcliff High School.
Engine 93 responding.
Yeah. is follow the garlic smell. Only the best is good enough for Briarcliff. Only the best is good enough for me. We've got a lot of delis. You'll never have to roam. Don't forget Chinese takeout. Doesn't anyone cook at home? Only the best is good enough for Briarcliff. Only the best is good enough for me. We want an education, the best, said by Mr. Law. Our schools must be the finest and better than Chappaqua. Only the best is good enough for Briarcliff. Only the best is good enough for me, everybody. Only the best is good enough for Briarcliff. Only the best is good enough for me.
Well, sir, your Briarcliff of today certainly seems pretty good. Actually, the best. And your lives are very full, even if you don't have any cows to milk. But the long leap between your generation and mine deserves a look, too. Several important things happened in the 20th century here that helped define your lives today. And you're going to experience some of them tonight, right now. So, back to the beginning. After 4 years of turning a quiet farming community into a thriving village, it wasn't long before the down county citizens began wondering what was going on up here in the wilderness. In 1902, when Briarcliff was founded, and the hit song was Bill Bailey, Won't You Please Come Home, even youngers, shopkeepers, who knew all the gossip, were mighty curious about their northern neighbors.
Well, there's a dairy farm up near Pleasantville. It's owned by Walter Law. He's building houses up there, up in the sticks. Hey, that's life in the raw. This former carpet king says we'll build a town like nothing else you ever saw. I'm packing up today and I'll be on my way. I'm even taking Ma and Pa, gentlemen. Aren't they great? Excuse me. This former carpet king says we'll build a town like nothing else you ever saw. So don't be surprised if they name it Briarcliff. For there's a name without a, there's a name without a, there's a name without a
team.
And in the teens, the library was founded and our farms had 500 pigs, 4,000 chickens, thoroughbred horses, pheasants, peacocks, and a flock of sheep. And we sent nearly 4,000 quarts of milk every day to New York on the train and got 12 cents for each one. We also grossed over $100,000 a year selling American Beauty roses, a fortune for the time. One of the not so nice things in the teens was sending 91 of our men off to fight in World War I. But one of the nicest things to do was rolling on the river, the Pocanico River, of course. I was in my 70s, but George Ann and I always managed to get a little exercise as well as sing pretty well together while paddling our canoe along those golden shores. Still have the calluses. And as the 20s were ushered in, so was a special friend of our family who still resides in Briarcliff today. And oh, how she resides. She's the embodiment of everything good about the town and its people. She's going to tell you a bit about her favorite times in our local history.
Okay. I'm Eileen Weber, and I was born in Briarcliff in 1918. And I'm here to tell you what the lodge meant to me, because growing up in Briarcliff, it was the whole thing that made Briarcliff. It was like a castle on the hill, and the Law family did so much to make it absolutely gorgeous. We had formal gardens, by the way, on Dalmany Road, where the newer colonials are now. In fact, the gardens were still there when I went to Edgewood Park. And then the houses that look that are white on Dalmany Road, they were the dairymen's houses. Now, back in those days, in 1910, 20, the millionaires all over the world came to the Briarcliff Lodge. It was considered the most outstanding hotel in the East. The Coronado was the outstanding one in the West. And the millionaires would come up to Scarborough on their yacht and stay the whole summer, or they'd come to the railroad station, which Mr. Law had carpeted with his good carpeting. He was in the carpeting business. And then he furnished it with Mission furniture. The family stayed all summer in those days. And we owe a lot to what the Briarcliff Lodge was, because it was so elegant, everybody talked about it. The Law family and the lodge and everything. But no, I got to tell you about the movie stars. Now, you got to remember, some of this thing I'm remembering, I'm 4 and 5 and whatever. But the one thing that impressed me very much was some Hollywood star. It wasn't Mary Pickford, because she'd been there with Douglas Fairbanks and everything. But somebody came up, and they had a limousine that was purple. And the footman had a purple uniform. And I thought that was the most glamorous thing I'd ever seen. And back in those days, Franklin Roosevelt came down for lunch and for dinner, because he was governor of New York, Al Smith did. And then that dashing darling Jimmy Walker, who was a lot of devilish about him, he would show up with his mistress, Betty Crompton. Now, the guests had many things to do, and they would play croquet, which the women did, and they'd also play tennis. And the tennis, by the way, they had 27 courts. Courts 1 and 2 were equal to Wimbledon and Forest Hills. And it was the most glamorous. I can see them all walking around in all their perfect whites. And the other thing we had was golf with Jean Saracen. And Gene Saracen, and I'm sure you golfers know, he won the PGA, the British Open, and the Masters, and he won another of the big Opens. He was absolutely sensational. Okay. Now, in 1924, they took the swimming pool, which is that pond in the back of the King's College, you know, and it was the largest swimming pool in America. And Johnny Weissmuller practiced there before the Olympics. And around the edge of the lake, the pond, which was the lake, but it was the pool then, I remember it was so glamorous. It had cabanas, and it looked like you were in Nice or the Riviera. And now the other thing is, they had skiing. And the first off the top, because Briarcliff, by the way, is one of the highest points of Briarcliff, and the Briarcliff Lodge, the first hole was up there, and you drove off, and you went down to the green on Dalmany Road. And it was quite a famous golf hole. And so what they did was, for the Olympic tryouts for skiing, they brought in snow from Canada in carloads, and they filled it up with the trucks. And under the trucks was booze, because it was prohibition. But the biggest thing about the lodge, with it so beautiful and lovely, I can hear the music now. You could have danced all night.
They walk danced and whined and laughed and dined at the Briarcliff Lodge.
They danced and dipped and talked and sipped at the Briarcliff Lodge.
A fireplace in all rooms, verandas and ballrooms.
They sang and played and dreamed and stayed at the Briarcliff Lodge.
Jimmy Walker and FDR, Tallulah, the Broadway star.
It's black tie and diamonds too, and opera stars that sing for you.
They sang and played and dreamed and stayed at the Briarcliff Lodge.
One day, and Betty, Betsy O'Leary said to me, Eileen, you know, at the induction service, you mentioned the alma mater. Do you know it? And I said, yes, I do, but I get it twisted with Edwin Park. I'll call you back. So I called Louise Quinn. Now, by the way, I'm going to be 84, and Louise Quinn is 86. So Louise Quinn, I say to her, Louise, do you remember the alma? Oh, of course, she knew it right away. So the two of us sang it and got sentimental about how great the high school was in our day. And then I stopped and I sang it to myself and I thought, the ending's not right. So I called Louise back and her line was busy. And then it turned out, I waited about a couple of minutes, and turned out at that point she was calling somebody in Hawthorne who was 87. And they knew all the words and had it all typed out. So what happened, and I've got to tell you this, Kay Courageous, which some of you know, wrote the words, and Lois Havrilla was a music teacher when I was this big. He did the music. So I'm going to give you the old alma mater that I used to do 69 years ago. So here it goes. Here's to our dear old BHS. We love you dearly and so sincerely. We'll always try to do our best. We'll never fail you in the test. So here's to our dear old school and to its colors true. Our school will lead the rest. Cheer for old BMHS. We all will see it through. The orange and the blue. Honor and love it too with loyal zest. Here we go.
Have you heard? We won today. Winning streak, you're here to stay. 40 points to nothing. What a real neat game. Though that other team was rough, Tufts and Cubs.
understand that's a great school. Eileen could have easily finished this little history lesson tonight, but told me that since she's going to be around a lot longer than I am, she'd like me to handle it. Gracious as always, that's Eileen. Briarcliff was a town without young adults in the early 40s. 20% of our total population served in World War II. And there was a great surge to the suburbs after the war was over in the late 40s and 50s. The town actually changed more in that decade than any decade before or since. The first shopping centers, the Putnam Division tracks disappeared, as you know, and Route 100 took their place as the railroad station became the library. Todd School opened in 1953. Banks actually opened here, and we finally got our own dial phones in 1959. But changes were not just limited to those you see. Many occurred in the things you feel, like music. Glenn Miller finally gave way to a new kind of music that swept the country and the world, rock and roll.
Did you hear?
What?
Eddie's gonna ask Betty to go study.
No, when?
No!
Oh, wow, where?
At the hop.
Stop.
Two. 1, 2, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, rock. 5, 6, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, rock. 9, 10, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, rock. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight. Put your glad flags up. Join me, happy. Have some fun when the clock strikes. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight. We're gonna rock, rock, rock till broad daylight. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight. When the clock strikes 2, 3, and 4.
Yeah!
Bye-bye, 50s. By 1960, there were almost 5,100 people in the village. We had more than doubled population in 10 years and tripled it in 20. The new village office building opened in 1964, and in June of the following year, 1965, the biggest social event of the decade took place, Bill Bowers Day. After nearly 40 years in our school system, this teacher, coach, friend, and confidant retired in an honorific blizzard of parades, presentations, and special parties. He was given a car and a boat. 3 weeks later, you didn't have to look far for him. He was substitute teaching. Where? Right here in Briar. Though most were happy to see the changes that progress requires, some wondered where Briarcliff was headed with all this population. In 1960, when Camelot was the Broadway hit, a major subject was lamenting the old, beloved Briarcliff.
Drinking, haven't had a sniff, but things have changed from comfortable past 10, says, in Briarcliff. Seems yesterday I took the train called Putman, and with my neighbors never had a tiff, and now the kids yell, hey, get off your butt, man, in Briarcliff. Briarcliff, Briarcliff, that once was quiet and serene. But Briarcliff, Briarcliff, the noise is now obscene. Where pets may never leave the house they live in, snow must be cleared away before it falls. Now let me tell you, if I could choose in a jiff, I'd go back 30 years to lovely, tranquil Briarcliff. Now let me tell you, if I could choose in a jiff, I'd go back 30 years to lovely, tranquil Briarcliff.
As we passed into the 70s, the new high school was built, and so was a home for senior citizens, North Hills. We started recycling, built paddle courts, and put a high-rise train platform at Scarborough Station. And we swelled with pride as our nation celebrated its 200th birthday. With all that was happening, we needed time out to relax. One of the favorite ways in the 70s and 80s was the hit show on television, Laugh-In, a sure tonic for a dizzying world, because it had an equally dizzying world all its own.
Tonight's edition of Laugh-In is brought to you by Briarcliff Table Water and Saucy Susan, both manufactured right here in lovely Briarcliff Manor.
Now here's an interesting fact. You guys know that in the early 1900s, Briarcliff was known as the rose capital of the entire United States. Put that in your funkin' wagons.
Boring! You know that. The Briar Rose, a poem by Brendan Carter. Once there were 8,000 roses sent to Manhattan each day. They were grown right here in our village. And that made us quite famous, they say. A Briar Rose. Thank you.
And guess what? 1908, it won the Paris Expo for the best butter and cream in the world.
Oh, yeah, I like butter and cream.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, I like butter and cream. Oh, yeah, my little cream puff. Let me sit down next to you. I gotta tell you a story. I know history facts is something that you don't want to share with anybody, but I think you and I can make some history.
Michael, stage. Go.
The mayor was arrested for speeding through town. It was good.
I missed my train the other day, and I was late for work.
What happened?
I was looking for a parking space.
Very interesting. Can you believe that in 1940 there were only 5 cars parked at Scarborough Station?
Very
good. Here's another one. Did you know there are more manicurists in Briarcliff than parking spaces?
I want to take you to Big Country for breakfast. Then I want to take you to Chihuahua Charlie's for lunch. Then I want to take you to the Wish 'Em Well for cocktails. And then I want to take you to Terra Rooster and cover you with tomato sauce.
What do you think of this? The first international car race was right here down Main Street in Briarcliff. Hong Kong!
Something, maybe if I show you how I dress, it'd make you happy and you'd date me. Look how handsome I am. Well, I'm gonna have to show you how beautiful I am. It works every time. Honey, we're not gonna have to move.
Ah, the 90s. Population reached 8,000 by the end of the old millennium, and there was lots new going on in town. New homes, new stores, new restaurants, and even a new golf course owner.
Start spreading the news. Are starting to drift up the Hudson River to Briarcliff. I want to live at Atlantic City down by the sea and come to your little town and make history. Saving for dues. I've built a brand new country club in Briarcliff. And if you join today, oh man, you're going to. It's up to you. Can't be beat and find my name on the course, then maybe the industry. Your little town's name, it drives me insane. I'll find a brand new name for you in Briarcliff. Yes, I'll pass up this dump, change Briarcliff's name to Trump. It's up to me in Briarcliff.
Odds are that man's bite is worse than his bark is worse than his bite. I have a feeling he's as fond of Briarcliff as we are. After all, he called it exquisite Briarcliff Manor in his advertising. Well, sir, that brings us right up to date. You've had a wonderful 100 years. Tomorrow you'll start writing the next chapter. And if all this is any indication, you've got a great start on the next 100. This is a program for a surprise testimonial dinner the farm employees had for me up on Dalmany Road in January of 1901. It was a great evening, and they asked me to say a few words, very few, and I should have this memorized, but it's been 100 years, so permit me to read just a little bit to you. What I want to impress tonight is that Briarcliff is so set that it shall be a light to this country in doing things well. It is not that we care so much to grow big, but that we have set ourselves for the purpose of lifting up the standard of everything we do. That the whole thought of this place is to so set our candle upon a candlestick that it may be a light to the whole country. If you do not see my face or hear my voice, my spirit will be here day by day and hour by hour. I shall not be gone long, I hope, and I know my feet will quicken their steps when I near Briarcliff again. You have a wonderful and incredibly unique town here. I know you'll look after it because you care. Whether we like it or not, yesterday is gone, and tomorrow is promised to no one. The only thing you have is today, but that's a lot. Work hard, have fun, learn from each other, love each other. It's been well worth the long trip back home to share this special evening with you. Have a great next 100 years, and even though I'm in my 160s, I will plan to meet you here in 2102. Thank you and good night.
Only the best is good enough for me. comments that I can say both nice performers. The cast, the crew, our committee, we want to dedicate this to Eileen Weber. Yeah!
Sticks.